So one day I had a conversation with an awesome watercolorist, Sean. We had a really good conversation about watercolor and painting, and he brought out this nice little palette called the Portable Painter's Classic. It's a lot of P's there. So what I'm gonna do is I purchased this. It cost about $30. And then I also purchased these brushes, which are really neat and fancy, but you screw them and then you can screw them together so that they're protected. And it's a nice long brush. We'll try out these brushes. We will try out this Portable Painter's Classic. It's ideal for travel and it is pocket sized. Isn't that great? All right, so let's open this up and see what we've got going on. Comes with a little booklet, the guy that invented it, which this is a really good design setup. So here we have two little sections. It's split into two. You can see the seam in the middle. You can take this, push it off, and that allows you to release both sides. Look at that. Isn't that great? Now, the nice thing about these can be paintbrush holders or water trays or both. And the little clip that's on the side there, that slides in between those plastic clips like that. And then we take the other side. There's the clip portion. Slide it between the two. So it's like that. And it is not perfectly level, but that's okay. It doesn't have to be. But the nice thing is we can take and put water in both these containers. You can have both of them for water or hold brushes. If we take a brush out of here, there's an indent. I don't know if you can see it. So there's an indent and then it comes up, and also on the other side, an indent comes up so that when you take your brush, you can set it on there. But this is meant to be on your leg, on your thigh. So if you have a really big thigh, it might not fit. I have a relatively thin thigh thanks to my chicken legs, so I'll be able to hold that on there. All right, let's get into the nitty-gritty. If we open it up, oh look, there's a double brush that it comes with. That's phenomenal. This one, you just unscrew the back like the other one, flip it around, put it together, and you have two brushes. That's so nice. Doesn't seem like very good quality, but that's okay. Okay, so each one of these are trays that you can put a different color in, and then you have mixing on this side, additional colors and or mixing on that side. So there's not very much real estate, but that's okay. You don't need to have a lot of real estate. All right, now that I have all of these trays set up, they should have like an adhesive in the bottom of them so that you can take them out and put them back into place in case you fill them up and you no longer want to use a certain color. But I'm going to have my tray set up a little bit differently. So I'm gonna have my colors down here and my values up here. When I say values, I'm gonna take this white, gray, and black and place them up in the top here. I'll probably do white, gray, and black, and then do colors down here and leave a couple of open spots so that if I want to add other colors or values, I can do that. Okay, I'm gonna take this thing outside and use it to paint. I have gouache. I like gouache more than watercolor because of the opacity. And so I'll take the colors, put them in there, we'll go outside, and I'm going to paint my pomegranate bush that is sitting out there. Okay, the colors that I have here, this is permanent white. This is neutral gray value 3. This is ivory black, primary yellow, primary red, magenta, primary blue, and permanent green. So those are the colors that I'm gonna use. I don't really need to have more. That will provide a lot of vibrancy for colors. It'll be hard to neutralize some of them with the mixed palette that I currently have. And I have these awesome little paint brushes. So let's go outside and do some painting.
Here I am outside in my orchard. I technically have like 52 fruit trees right now, or fruit bearing things. And the pomegranate looked really good at this time of the year. It is October, and I thought that I would just paint it because the red pomegranates versus the green foliage looks really nice. And then I have a bunch of wood chips on the ground, and so it has some gray tones that are in there. But when I'm out here painting it and I set this up, I ran into a couple of problems. First off, the camera kept recording my freaking head instead of the painting that I was working on. And so it zooms in and out, and sorry about that, but you know, gotta focus. I guess I should have fixed the focus at that depth, but I was alone when I was painting this. So this is what you get. I just used those simple colors when painting it in. I should have done a nice thin wash before starting to work on some of the detail. As you can see right here, that I'm making some corrections on those darker values of the greens. And I want to make it a little bit more gray in the background. But there was some nice light that was coming in off to the side. You could see the light behind me as it's going onto part of the paper. And coming in with a small detailed brush to put in the little sticks and twigs that are coming out of the ground of the pomegranate bush before I start to paint in those pomegranates. Now, the tricky thing with watercolor and gouache is that when it dries, it tends to change color and value. You can see here that I put in a nice red and then it starts to turn more orange. So I had to keep on pushing the values and the chroma in different directions to see if it would land in the right spot. And that's kind of the trick with gouache. But overall, I feel like I made a successful little painting and a study and to experiment with this palette outside. It worked really good. It was stable on the leg. I was able to mix with it, no problems whatsoever. The water was easy to mix there. It's just really kind of dry outside. So I really like how it felt on my leg. It was comfortable. It didn't pinch or anything. I think I want to make a nice little holder for my canvas when I go out and paint in the future. Now that I'm done with this little gouache painting, thing that I would like to have done better is create more asymmetry as opposed to having it so symmetrical, but you know, we'll learn stuff as I go on. But I feel like it was a relatively successful. I got some good notes of difference between red and oranges and the blues that were coming on the top of the pomegranate, the color changes of the greens and gouache out side. I was having a hard time seeing the color changes and the value changes. But now that I'm in the studio lighting where I can see things relatively clean and clearly, there are obviously some things that I'd like to change. So that's in terms of the painting. Now let's talk about the traveling boxes. Well, before I get to that, I'm going to talk about this paintbrush that I used. Okay, so this paintbrush was really good. Let's see if I can get it up close. There we go. I really enjoyed this paintbrush. It was soft. It made a really nice tip. If I wanted to do washes, I could do washes. There's the title. I'll put the brushes in the link below. It was a really good brush. The brush that came actually with the portable painter, I don't think it was that good, but it worked. Okay. So I have these two little boxes that I purchased. You can see the size difference between the two. This one was $16, this one was $26. Now, the nice thing about this one is that it's metal. And you could take these little trays out. You had to buy the trays separate. They were about $8. So pretty close to the same price between these two things. I like the real estate that is available on this one. I was able to mix colors relatively easy. And then I put some Velcro on the bottom of these to be able to attach them
and make sure that they would stay in place, because these are flimsy and they would slide back and forth. Whereas if you fill them all in to the side there, so you can see there's not much movement or sliding with these separate guys, but these would just slide back and forth, and that is not very good. So I got Velcro and put it in the bottom of it to be able to attach it, which allows me to be able to pull it out like that. See, so easy. I can put it back into its spot and it doesn't move around that much. Now the paint will, but either way, the nice thing that I like about this box is it's adjustable. You can have fewer colors or a lot more colors. You have a couple of spots that you can mix, and also down here that you can mix. The downside is durability. This clasp here is just a metal indent. And let me see if I can, you can see it there. Metal indent. And that's where it clips on, is through that. But if I have it shifted just a little bit, it comes out really easily. That's not so good. The bottom part, this is nice, a good little addition. This is for your finger. So if you're left-handed, you can put your finger through that and hold the palette like this so that it stays. You don't have to grip the palette that much, but it holds it relatively well with the finger. The downside is I'm mixing here and then I have nowhere to hold my canvas or watercolor paper. So taking that into consideration, you can set it down onto a surface, but you have to have a flat surface. And I tried to do that on the beach and it became really difficult. So I had basically my vellum paper on my lap while I was trying to paint, and it was creating little indents and stuff. It just wasn't the best scenario. So in terms of traveling, this will work good, but in the end with those little dividers, it was the same cost. This was the same cost as this. Okay, now we're going to talk about the pros and cons of this guy. Pro, nice and portable, keeps this nice and sealed. As you remove it, you can slide them in there, as I already demonstrated before. And you have places to be able to put water. So it kind of knocks it off balance a little bit if you have just one side with water and the other not with water. And I spilled my water yesterday when I was getting set up because it was a little bit off balance. But if you keep brushes on this and water in this, it keeps it pretty well balanced. The nice thing I like about this is I can just put this on my leg.
And just to clarify, this is 5.5 inches wide and 2.25 inches high, so it fits nicely on my leg.
So it straddles my leg relatively fine. It doesn't pinch. If you have large legs, then I could see how this might be a problem or might not sit on your leg very well. I have a friend that what he did is he constructed a piece of wood that he placed in between the two, and it went around these supports, and then he made a clip on the bottom of it to be able to go into a tripod so he didn't have to have it on his leg anymore. So I thought that was a nice adjustment that he made. But the innovation in this thing is just stellar. Keeping your water in there, holding the brushes, you can have two brushes that it'll hold, and when you open it up, it has a good amount of real estate in there. So less colors in your trays, which again, I'm totally fine with, but you do have more mixing areas in here, and it does come with a nice little small brush. So in terms of compactness and complete availability, this is awesome, it's stellar. I had this on my leg, I had my painting on my other leg, and I was able to just go back and forth and paint, and it was really, really stable. So would I recommend this over this? You better believe it, simply because hands-free and I have water available, whereas this, I don't have the water available and I need to have a hand or some type of support that I'm making over it. I do like that it's metal. I don't like how it sounds. I mean, that's the paintbrush making that noise, but this feels more stable and secure than this one. So my recommendation, yes, I would totally get this. Is it worth the $30? I totally believe it's worth the $30. And even for students, this would be a really good option to bring into class because you have everything right there and available. Unless you like to have a lot of space, then that might be a problem. But for students, I would totally recommend this. So portable painter, I give it a thumbs up. My thumb looks weird in that direction. Two thumbs up. This one, on the other hand, I'd give it one thumb up because the inside of my hand, the underside of my hand would be taken up by holding it. See, and that's just not very fun. All right, the last thing that I like about this, even your water cups, everything, you can take it, put it over. Oh, make sure that you have the clip up, not down. And when I say up, the name here, if I can get a highlight on it, there you can see a little bit better. But the name here is going to be up. And I make sure that these little clips are up so that when I put this on it, it will secure it. The other nice thing is it has this rubber band, and you can take this and put it in the rubber band or paint brushes into the rubber band to kind of hold it off to the side. It's really nice. And in terms of size, there's really not that much of a difference in terms of depth. You can see that. It is a little bit wider, but that's okay. And if I stack it on top of each other, they're about the same depth and height. This is just a little bit wider, which again, totally good with. So highly recommend, okay with recommending, but if you could just spend another $5, I would totally get this. Along with these compact brushes, look at that, it just fits together. You can put that in a nice little bag and not have to worry about not having enough space. If you have these along with your art piece, that's really not that much, space that you're using. All right, I hope that that review was informative and beneficial. Please let me know your thoughts or comments about it. And yes, I would totally get this. In fact, I might have my students buy it for watercolor so that they have a nice enclosed transportable palette. All right, I hope you all have a stellar day, and paint on.